Hey friends, I'm Tasia, and this video will show you how to have a more secure Zoom video chat. With stay-at-home orders and people working from home, Zoom video meetings are more popular than ever, and you'd be living under a rock if you haven't heard of Zoom. However, with the rise in popularity of Zoom video chats comes a concern over Zoom security settings, and many people are asking, is Zoom safe to use? So if you have Zoom security concerns but need to use it for meetings, ensure you're taking the following steps to better secure your Zoom account. Number one, don't use your personal meeting ID for the meeting. Instead, use a non-recurring meeting ID or a per meeting ID, which is used for one meeting and one meeting only. Basically, you want to generate a random link for one use only. Your profile may or may not already be set up this way, but to check, sign into your Zoom account on the web and click on My Account. Under this profile section, click edit to the right of the personal meeting ID section and make sure the use personal meeting ID for instant meetings is toggled off. You can also see these options in your settings section, which we'll head to next. Number two, set a password for the meeting. Again, from the Zoom web portal, head to your settings. Scroll down here and ensure you've toggled on the option for both require a password when scheduling new meetings and require a password for instant meetings. If you're going to use your personal meeting ID, make sure you're password protecting those meetings too. I have all of my password protection options enabled here. Number three, authenticate participants for the meeting. In that same settings section, make sure only authenticated users can join meetings. This will require participants to sign in and essentially authenticate themselves prior to joining the meeting. Number four, don't allow participants to join the meeting before you, the host. Again, from the settings, make sure the join before host is toggled off. Number five, enable the waiting room feature. This way you can see who's trying to join your meeting before you allow or deny them access. How to do this will differ on the Zoom account type you have, but for individual users, you'll head to the Meetings tab found in your Settings section. Now click the In Meeting Advanced option. Scroll down to Waiting Room and make sure that's enabled. On this note, I've also got the option to allow removed participants to rejoin meetings toggled off. So if someone did get through and join your meeting and you've removed them, they can't get back in. And to further make sure this doesn't happen to you, I bring you number six, lock your meeting. Once a meeting has begun and all your participants have joined, head to the Manage Participants tab. Click More and choose to lock the meeting. This way, even if your meeting ID has been accessed, the hacker won't be able to join your already in progress meeting. Number seven, turn off participant screen sharing. From your settings section, click In Meeting Basic and scroll down and you'll see quite a few screen sharing options. Here you can toggle on the option for host only to share the screen. You could also enable the feature to disable desktop screen share for users. Now, if you want to do this on a per meeting basis, you can do this during the meeting as well in the security section. Number eight, disable file sharing. I always recommend that you have your participants share any necessary files via email or Dropbox or whatever other format you have prior to starting your Zoom meeting. So in your basic meeting section, just above all those screen sharing options we went over, you'll be able to disable the file transfer option here too. Last but not least, be sure you're checking for updates to the Zoom software. Oftentimes, these software updates will include bug fixes and address security concerns. So those are my tips on how to secure your Zoom video chat. Do you have Zoom security concerns? How have you addressed them? Let everybody know in the comments below. As always, thank you guys so much for watching. If you like this video, I wanna know, so give it a like, a share, or leave a comment below. You can click right about here to subscribe to my channel and somewhere up here for another video. Thanks for watching, guys. We'll see you next time.